Periodontium is the tissue that attaches and supports the tooth to the jaw. It is formed of four separate tissues, among which two are soft tissues, two are hard tissues. Gingiva, periodontal ligament, cementum, and alveolar bone. The space between the alveolar bone proper or the bony socket and the cementum is the periodontal space. This space is filled by a ligament called periodontal ligament. A ligament by definition is a fibrous connective tissue which joins two bones together. Periodontal ligament is the only ligament connecting a tooth to a bone. So, periodontal ligament is a fibrous joint that anchors the root of the tooth to the alveolar bone socket. Its other names are periodontal membrane, alveolar dental ligament, desmodont, pericementum, dental periosteum, gomphosis. The periodontal ligament has an average width of around 0.2 mm and has an hourglass shape. That is, the ligament is wide near the cervical line, narrow in the middle, and wide again at the apex. Being a fibrous joint, it has many fibers, like collagen fibers, oxytalin fibers, reticular fibers, secondary fibers, and indifferent fibers. Among these fibers, collagen fibers form more than 90%. Among the collagen fibers, type 1 collagen forms 70%, type 3 collagen 20%, and type 4, 5, 6, 7, and 12 collagen form the rest 10%. The collagen fibers in periodontal ligament have the fastest turnover rate. Most of the collagen fibers are arranged in bundles called principal fibers. Oxytalin fibers run perpendicular to the oblique fibers. One end is embedded in cementum or bone and the other in the walls of blood vessels. Reticular fibers are related to the base membrane of blood vessels and epithelial rests. Secondary fibers are relatively non-directional and randomly oriented. Indifferent fibers form a plexus of fibers. Now coming to the principal fibers. They are the collagen fibers that are arranged in bundles, 5 microns in diameter, running from the cementum to the alveolar socket and play the main role in anchoring the tooth. The anchored part of these principal fibers at both ends, alveolar bone and cementum, are called Sharpe's fibers. Like if a bridge is compared to a principal fiber, its anchored parts on both ends will be the Sharpe's fibers. In the theories of tooth eruption, according to the periodontal ligament traction theory, it is the contraction of these principal fibers that pulls the tooth out of the alveolar bone to its functional position. Their development. During tooth development, the dental sac or dental follicle gives rise to the periodontal ligament. Cells of the dental sac differentiate into fibroblasts and start forming collagen fibers. As the tooth continues developing and erupting, these fibers elongate towards each other, meet in the center, and form a bundle. Principal fibers are classified into 5 groups: alveolar crest group, horizontal group, oblique group, interradicular group, and apical group. They are named either according to their location in the ligament or their direction. Let us start with the first group of fibers, alveolar crest fibers. They are the first group to develop. They extend from the cementum just beneath the cemento-enamel junction to the crest of the alveolar bone. These fibers resist tilting, intrusive, extrusive, and rotational forces. The next group of fibers, horizontal fibers. They develop after development of the alveolar crest fibers. These fibers run from the cementum to the alveolar bone in a horizontal direction. They are limited in the cervical third of the root. They resist tilting and horizontal forces. Coming to the next group, oblique fibers. They develop after the horizontal group and are the most abundant group of fibers. They cover almost 2/3 of the ligament. Their insertion at the alveolar bone is coronal to their attachment in the cementum. These fibers resist intrusive and extrusive forces. The next group of principal fibers, interradicular fibers. These fibers are present only in teeth with multiple roots and absent in single-rooted teeth. They extend from the crest of the interradicular septum to the furcation area of the root. These fibers resist tilting, torquing, and extrusive forces. Finally, the last group of fibers, apical fibers. These fibers are the last group to form. They are inserted at the apex of the root and radiate to the fundus or the bottommost part of the socket. They protect the tooth from extrusive forces. So that was about the fibers of the periodontal ligament. Now if we take a look at the gingiva, there are some fibers in its connective tissue called gingival fibers which collectively form the gingival ligament. They are also classified into five groups. They are named according to their two insertion points or their directions. Let us take a look at these gingival fibers individually. Dentogingival group. These fibers extend from the cementum to the connective tissue of free gingiva and attached gingiva. Among all gingival fibers, these are the most numerous. Alveolo-gingival group. These fibers extend from the crest of the alveolar bone to the connective tissue of free gingiva and attached gingiva. Circular group. These fibers are not inserted into any hard tissue. They run circularly around the tooth, that is, from the occlusal aspect of the tooth, in the free gingiva around the neck of the tooth, these fibers run circularly. Dentoperiosteal group. These fibers extend from the cementum, run over the crest of the alveolar bone and get inserted into the periosteum of the alveolar bone. And finally, transseptal fibers. These fibers are limited only in the interdental gingiva. These fibers extend from one tooth, run over the crest of interdental alveolar bone and get inserted into the adjacent tooth. Together, these fibers of all the teeth in the arch form the transseptal fiber system, collectively being called as the interdental ligament, which connects all teeth in the arch.